So in this lecture, we are going to discuss the third module of our subject C, Part 11, Principles of Transportation Engineering. So this will now cover the topic of the traffic studies. Okay, so when we talk about traffic studies, this would generally involve both time and money. Thus, we have to plan ahead of time all our data collections. So what does this mean? So pag gumagawa tayo ng traffic studies, hindi lang naman siya isang oras na ginagawa. So we have to observe it for several hours for a certain number of days. So sometimes aabot yan ng isang linggo or sometimes a month. The longest would be a year or probably more than 1 year. So pag habang ginagawa natin yan, syempre, madami tayong kailangan para mabilang or makuha yung data natin. So, meaning, kailangan natin gumastos. Kasi hindi mo naman kayang bilangin as one person lahat ng mga data na kailangan mo for a traffic study. So, para magkaroon tayo ng magandang traffic study at hindi tayo masyadong gumastos, we have to plan on specific days, specific times, gaano katagal mo gagawin yung traffic study mo. So, that is what the first statement means. Also, for a traffic study, these are performed in order to analyze our traffic characteristics. So, we perform traffic studies in order to collect data so that we could analyze and describe the characteristic of traffic flow in a certain area. So, this would now help us in geometric design and traffic control for a safe and efficient traffic movement. So, this is the purpose now of conducting your traffic studies. So, it helps us identify kung ano ba yung magandang design or kailangan ba ng rehabilitation or renovation ng highway natin. Okay? So, for our traffic studies, we would have different types of traffic studies conducted, and we have actually three. The first one is what we call your volume studies, and the second one is the spot speed study, and the last type of traffic study is what we call your travel time and delay studies. Okay? So, for the first type of traffic study, which is your volume studies, this is now conducted in order for us to obtain factual information or real information on the number of vehicles and or persons that is passing at a specified point on a highway system. So from the name itself, the volume studies now would basically be a study in which we want to identify the volume at which the section of highway or of a road na pinag-aaralan natin yung kaya niyang or yung dumadaan dun sa section na yun. Okay? So, the resulting volume now or data are expressed in relation to time. So, we have different types of volume. That is your annual traffic, our annual average daily traffic, hourly traffics, and short-term count. Okay? So, also, in volume studies, we'll have different types of collected data. And this will include your mid-block counts, directional counts, turning or intersection counts, classification counts, cordon counts, and your screen line counts. So, ano ba yung mga types of volume sa ano ba yung definition ng collected data natin? So, we start off first with the types of volume that we gather in your volume study and what are their uses. So the first one is your annual traffic, which is now used to determine the annual travel of a section or of a highway. It is used to estimate the expected highway user revenue and compute accident rates. So from your highway engineering, you were able to compute accident rates, and the volume used there is the annual traffic, okay? The next type of volume that we gather is what we call your annual average daily traffic, or your AADT, which is a measure of the present demand for service by road, and it is used for programming capital improvements. So for accident rates, that's your annual traffic. For improvements, for geometric design, we use your AADT. So the next type is your hourly traffic. So from the name itself, it is the volume of vehicles or of persons measured per hour. So it is used to evaluate the capacity deficiencies of a road section. It's also used for the design of your or improvement of your street and intersection. And lastly, we have your short-term counts, which is used to estimate maximum flow rates and to determine the characteristic of your peak hour volume. Okay? So, next one are the types of collected data or data collected for your volume studies. So the first one is what we call your classification counts. So a classification counts identifies vehicle types by the number of axles and distance between your axles. So we have here an example of classification. So it's by motorcycles, passenger cars, buses, trucks, or the like. So for classification counts, ang ginagawa natin, binibilang natin yung mga sasakyan based sa classification nila. So, bibilangin ko, ilang motor yung dumadaan sa kalsada, ilang kotse or private vehicles, ilang bus, ilang jeep. So, that is for your classification counts. So, a classification count now will be used for the following. It's used to determine the modal split to be used in our design or in our models of a road section. So, it's used for estimating the effects of heavy vehicles on a capacity. And it's used to determine correction factors for automatic counts. So we'll be discussing modal split during the finals. So when we say modal split, gaano ba karami yung gumagamit na sasakyan for a certain route? So parang gan. So explain natin to later on. But anyways, for a classification count, we use it for your modal split. So also, ito, heavy vehicles or its effect. So, based on your classification counts, you now know how many buses, how many trucks, how many big vehicles will be passing through your road section. So, you'll be able to see kung ano ba yung effect niya. Meron, nagiging cause ba siya ng traffic or hindi. So, that's for classification count. So, the next type of collected data are your screen line counts. A screen line count now is an example of a classification count, which is taken now at in an imaginary line, which bisects a given area. So your imaginary line could either be a man-made or a natural barrier. So hanap ka ng parang point mo kung saan yun yung magiging imaginary line natin. So that imaginary line, dun mo bibilangin yung mga sasakyan mo. Okay, so the data now used or the data gathered from a screen line count is used to compare the traffic capacities in the path of your traffic flow. So the next type of collected data is what we call your mid-block counts, which is also known as your road volume data report or your link counts. So this one now is used for preparing traffic flow maps, which helps us to determine the trends of vehicles. So how do vehicles arrive or depart from a certain road section? Okay, so it's used to measure the total vehicle volume and vehicle classification. So it's most likely related to our classification counts. Another one is what we call your directional counts. So, this is used for directional distribution for capacity analysis. So, we'll be able to identify now how many vehicles would turn right, would turn left, would turn, or would go straight forward the an intersection or a road section. So, this is used for signal timing and justifying our traffic controls. Okay? So, next type is what we call your cordon counts. So, it's used to determine the number of vehicles or persons entering and leaving an enclosed area. So, cordon yung ginagamit nung parang sa police. So, mag-identify ka ng area mo lang kung saan mo bibilangin yung mga sasakyan mo. Hindi mo bibilangin yung sa isang line lang kunwari na dadaanan niya. So, you'll, for cordon counts, this is for a certain area already. So, this would include directional traffic counts at selected sites. So, cordon counts, kasama dito, pwede nating isama yung sa directional counts ninyo or yung sa mga intersections. So, next, we have what we call your turning movement count or also known as your intersection counts. So, this enumerates the number of left turn, right turn, U-turn, and through movements for each approach made by vehicles or pedestrians. So, this is used to design or improve the geometry of intersections, signal installation and timing, pavement markings, and others that would help us manage our traffic flow. So, this is used now for planning or turning, for planning turning prohibitions and analyzing high accidents in intersections. So, it's also related to our directional counts. So, with this, so kung ito yung intersection, bibilangin natin ilan ba yung magpapa right turn, left turn, hindi diretso, o kaya kung pwedeng mag-U-turn, kung rotonda ito, kung ilan yung mag-U-turn doon. So, that's for turning movement count. So, for volume studies, we'll now be performing this for certain periods of time. So, we have what we call the time of studies. So, the time and duration of the traffic volume would depend on what type of data are we going to collect and what will be its application. So, para saan ba yung kinokollect nating data. And for our time of study, we have different or we have several times at which we count our volume studies. The first one is our 24-hour count. So, it means we count it the whole day. So, it's usually done midnight to midnight. So, examples would be for your mid-block count. So, if I want a mid-block count, I'll be performing a 24-hour count. So, magbibilang ako ng sasakyan ng buong araw. Okay? So, next, we have what we call your 16-hour count. So, this usually represents most of our daily flow and night traffic. So, kung hindi kaya ang 24-hour count, pwede rin 16-hour count. Kasi at least na ma-maximize pa rin natin yung daily flow, yung flow niya during daytime and nighttime. So, usually, it's done from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. as usual traffic occurs or starts at 6 and usually ends at 10 p.m. Pero pwede siyang magpalit depending on our locations or depending on the characteristic of your area. So, pag residential, usually 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. Kung business area yon, iba ulit yung magiging time natin. Pero usually, it's 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. So, another one, we have what we call your 12-hour count. So, we cover usually daytime traffic dito. So, hindi natin kinakonsider yung nighttime traffic. So, it's usually done from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. So, again, it could change based on the characteristic of your area. Kung residential ba, institutional, or commercial yung area ninyo. So, we also have the next one, your peak period counts. So, it's done at intervals of very high traffic volume. So, what does this mean? We usually only take collections of our data at times wherein alam natin doon yung pinakamataas ang traffic. Okay? So, that is usually at the morning, midday, and the evening. So, you have at 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. or pwede siyang 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. So, we have 11 a.m. to 1 p.m., 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. So, this could also change based on the location. Okay? So, next, we have your short counts. So, these are data collected for intervals of 5 to 15 minutes for about 1 hour or less. So, this is used to analyze peak hours characteristic. Okay? So, usually, yung peak period counts natin, ang ginagawa natin pag nagbibilang dyan, gagamit tayo ng short counts. So, from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m., dito ako magbibilang for the morning. Pero yung pagbilang ko, hatiin ko siya for every 5 or 15 minutes. So, meaning, magbibilang ako 7 a.m. to 7:15. Yung magbibilang ako doon. Tapos, from 7:15, mag-start ulit ako sa 1 ng bilang. Tapos, pag 7:30, start ulit ako sa 1 ng bilang. Yun yung ibig sabihin ng short counts natin. And we do it for 1 hour or less. So, example of short counts, this would include your intersection counts and pedestrian counts. Okay, so please take note for the time of study, abnormal conditions of a road section would always be or should be avoided unless yung purpose ng pagbilang natin is to take or gather data which will define that condition. So, ano ba yung abnormal conditions na tinatawag natin? So, this would now include special occasions such as holidays or fiestas. Kaya yung mga parada. So, days with abnormal weather conditions, bumabagyo ba? So, hindi ako kukuha ng data doon. Pero kung ang gusto kong malaman is gaano ba karaming sasakyan or ano ba yung traffic flow pag bumabagyo, then that's the only time that I will get the data or collect data. Okay? So, another abnormal condition would include your strikes, rallies, and demonstration. So, kung ang hanapin ko is the traffic flow on a regular basis, tapos, dun sa araw na yun, may strike, hindi ako magbibilang kasi maapektuhan yung ibang count ko. Pero kung ang gusto kong malaman, again, ay yung traffic flow or yung information ng traffic flow, ng karakteristik ng flow, pag may strike or pag may rally, then dun ako magbibilang. Pag hindi ko kailangan sa study ko, yung traffic flow during these days, ang gusto ko yung normal or yung regular flow, then hindi ako magbibilang during these conditions. Okay? So, there are several methods in performing volume studies. The first one is what we call tallying. So, in tallying, this will now be the simplest and most practical method used if we have no mechanical or automatic counting devices. So, it's used to record the number of vehicles passing or pedestrians passing. So, it depends on what data we are going to collect, but it's simply counting how many vehicles or pedestrians would pass a certain road section. So, you simply count it and then record it on a tally sheet. So, this may be used when the traffic volume is generally low and when we have observing a certain intersection or turning movement that has a very low volume. So, bakit low volume lang siya ginagamit? Kasi, syempre, hindi naman natin kayang bilangin yung mga sasakyan pag aabot na ng 1,000 yan, nahirapan na tayo. So, kung medyo konti lang yung mga sasakyang dumadaan, tallying yung pinakasimpleng gamitin. So, this one now is an example of a recorded volume study using our tallying. So this is tally sheet. So as you can see, we have counted it for every 15 minutes for a certain time. So it was counted from 6 o'clock to 15. So, and then we have here the vehicle classes. So we have here cars. So it could be private or public as long as it is a car. Then we have here your buses, truck. So kung sa Philippines, meron tayong jeepney. Pero pag sa ibang bansa to, ang meron dyan would be car, bus, truck, and others. So ito yung sinasabi ko kanina, pag sa short-term counts, it would be done 5 or 15 minutes interval for at least or for at most 1 hour. So every 15 minutes, mag-uumpisa tayong magbilang. Tapos bibilangin natin per vehicle class. And then you can see now here that for the first 15 minutes, there are a total of 30 vehicles that would pass, all types of vehicles. And then we could also see which among the different vehicle classes passes through that section of road the most. So from this data, we could see that cars would be the vehicle class that is passing most on the road section, followed by our buses. Okay? Tapos may kita din natin dito that from 6 o'clock to 6:45, we could see na yung pinakamaraming volume ng sasakyan na dumating is at 6:15 to 6:30. So, we could get many data or information just by simply counting our vehicles per 15 minutes or at short-term counts. Okay? So, the next method for counting volume for our volume studies is by our manual counters. So it's a mechanical device that is useful when we have volume or high volume. So this is used when tallying is not applicable anymore. So it may be a single or a multiple type manual counter. So an example of a manual counter is shown here. So pag magbibilang tayo, just push on or press on this button and then every time that there is a vehicle passing, so magbabago na yung bilang ninyo. So you have here your reset button whenever. So kunwari tapos na yung 15 minutes mo, reset mo siya, magbibilang siya ulit from 1. So the next method is by using your automatic counters. So it's a more sophisticated method already. So the traffic count, or this is used when the traffic count is done for a very long duration, such as your 24-hour counts. Kasi hindi naman tayo pwedeng magbilang tallying or manual counters pag kailangan mo siyang bilangin all throughout the day. So this is more applicable. So this is used through the use of your detectors, such as a pneumatic tube. So ito yung pinakasimple. So it's just laid out on the road. And then whenever a vehicle passes this pneumatic tube, then it would count now the vehicle. So as long, pag nadaanan na siya, that's a count 1. So it's the more sophisticated automatic counters or detectors used for automatic counters will be your ultrasonic waves or inductance loops. So mini-measure naman niya. So based doon sa speed ng sasakyan nyo, mabibilang din niya kung ilan yung dumadaang sasakyan. So, to better understand your automatic counters, we have here an example. So, this is a traffic counter system using inductive loops connected to a cabinet with a solar panel and a 3G modem to transmit the traffic information. So, we have here your, ito, yung box dito. Ito yung inductive loops ninyo. So, andito yung box ninyo for the power. and the 3G modem. So, pagdadaan yung sakyan, magbibilang siya. So, this naman is a pneumatic road tube counter. So, the tube is on the roadway and your counting device is on the sidewalk. So, ito yung counting device. So, pagdadaan yung sakyan sa tube na to, so, counting starts already. Okay, so we have another example of your automatic counters. So, this one uses a radar-based traffic counter. So, it's solar-powered. So, ito yung solar power ninyo. Ito yung sa may camera ninyo, which counts the traffic volume or the traffic flow. Then, this one naman sa pedestrian naman or counter, biker counter in Copenhagen. With display showing the number of bikes on a particular day and accumulate for the year for one bike lane. So, ito kung ilan na yung dumaan for that day. And then, this one is for the accumulated or the total number of bikes passing this counter. Okay? So, lastly, we could do our volume studies or our counting through the use of your video cameras, your traffic cameras. So, counts may be carried out through tallying or manual method while watching the video footage of a traffic flow. So, automatic counts can also be performed using an equipment and commercially available software for vehicle tracking. So, for video cameras or the use of video cameras, it can be a manual or a automated counting. So, an example, we have here your traffic cameras. So, it records now the flow. So, pwede nyong bilangin ngayon kung ilan yung dumada ang sasakyan through the recorded video. So, this one is a software, a system used to count traffic flow. So, as you can see, ito yung area na pagbibilangan natin. So, parang ito yung cordon ninyo. So, ito lang yung bibilangan kung ilang sakyan. So, nakita nyo yung mga green, naka-highlight ng green yung mga sakyan. Yan yung mga nabibilang na vehicles dito sa ating counting zone. So, based on the software ninyo, pwede nyong iset kung yung total volume of vehicles lang yung bibilangin or pwede nyo siyang iset kung yung right turn lang, left turn, yung passing through ang bibilangin. Okay? So, the data collected from our traffic volume or volume studies from the given methods can be presented in several ways. So, how do we represent them? So, this could be represented in various graphical forms so that readers who are do not have a background in traffic engineering or transportation engineering can easily understand the data. So, the first presentation of traffic volume is through variations. So, it presents traffic volume data through graphs or diagrams. So, it's the simplest and easiest way to understand the changes of traffic volume over a period of time or over a distance. The second one are our traffic flow maps. So, it's a map showing the movement of your vehicles. And lastly, we have your intersection diagrams. So, this shows inbound and outbound flow of traffic at our intersections. So, to understand these three types or three ways of presenting our traffic volume, we have examples on the next slides. So, this one is our variation. So, have here a graph showing us the volume of traffic inbound and outbound. So, pag sabi natin inbound, yung papasok doon sa counting zone natin, outbound yung palabas. So, basing from this given data or this given graph, makita natin na mas konti yung inbound compared sa outbound. So, mas mataas yung value or yung volume of vehicles that goes out of our counting zone. Okay? So, you can have this per day or pwede din siyang per week depending on the study you are conducting. So, next we have our traffic flow maps. So, this are examples of traffic flow maps. So, we use the map of the location we are observing. And then, you can use different legends to show the traffic, the volume or the daily traffic. So, sa figure na to, it uses different sizes of boxes. So, yung pinakamaliit would show 100,000 passenger car units. So, yung pinakamataba would be your 400. So, makita natin dito. So, yung outside Metro Manila, medyo maliit lang siya. Yung papuntang Manila area sa mismong center, medyo malalaki siya. So, you can easily understand that there's more traffic in this area. Another example we have here. So, dito daily traffic ang pinapakita. Dito naman is the movement of the vehicles. So, in our legend for this picture, so red would be a slow movement, green is a fast movement. So, basing on our traffic flow map, I can see that much more of most or majority of the roads are fast flowing. So, ibig sabihin, wala masyadong traffic. Yung may traffic, usually yung mga nasa slow movement natin. So, itong mga red colors. Okay? So, kahit hindi ako traffic engineer, hindi ako transportation engineer, based on using this diagrams, I can easily understand kung ano ba yung situation ng traffic doon sa area or sa city na yun. Okay? So, another example of a flow map is this one. So, ito naman, parang doon sa first figure natin, pero ito ang pinapakita niya is true circles. So, you can see, we can see na dito sa area na to, mas marami ang volume of traffic ninyo. The colors could be representing the route. So, we have different routes. So, this is route A for the orange part. So, for route B, sabi natin, ito, route B. Makikita natin yung route B, hindi masyadong traffic yung route na yon, kasi medyo maliliit lang yung volume natin sa mga stops. So, route C, meron siyang isang portion na doon ang traffic. Okay? So, these are examples of your traffic flow maps. And then, lastly, we have your intersection diagrams. So, this is an example. So, for intersection, so we have outbound. So, outbound, this one. So, may inbound din. So, two-way siya. Okay? So, yung diagram na ito, I can see that from, so this 1997 na value, it means galing dito sa B Boulevard, yung 1997, may 68 na pupunta pakaliwa. Tapos, merong 1712 na papuntang dederecho. At merong 217 na papuntang A Boulevard. So, nakikita natin. So, it shows us the total number ng papasok doon sa intersection at yung numbers nung mga saan pupunta yung mga vehicles ninyo. Kung paano nahati yung mapaparating na sasakyan. So, itong 5220 will be the total number of vehicles that would come from all directions. Okay? So 5220, ito yung total ng papunta, yung pumasok sa section na to, tapos yung paalis sa section na to. So, meaning, itong 1910, it means there is 15 that came from the left side, 1712 that came from B Boulevard, and 183 that came from A Boulevard. So, naintindihan naman siya. Okay? So, there should be directional arrows as much as possible for us to understand these values. So, we have here another example of your traffic flow maps. So, ito hindi siya arrow pero meron tayong color coding. Okay? So, 1540, nahati siya, mayroong papuntang west, may papuntang east, at may papuntang south. So, pag tinutal natin, 354, 863, saka 323, it's a total of 1540 vehicles. Okay? So, ito. And then, this 1360, it would go, or 326 manggagaling dito. Tapos, may 721 na manggagaling sa east, papuntang west, at may 313 manggagaling doon. So, kulang lang yung data natin. So, mas maganda yung arrows ang gamit para mas maintindihan yung diagram kung saan galing at saan mapapunta. Okay? So, for your volume studies, as we have said, we have different types of volumes that we collect. Okay? So, the most common will be our AADT and ADT. So, what is the difference between the two? So, when we say AADT, or this is our average annual daily traffic, this is now the common measure of our daily traffic for a given location. So, at a given point, it is estimated as the total volume counted over a year divided by the number of days in a year. Okay, so it's given simply as the sum of vehicles that would pass our point of study all throughout the year divided by 365. So it's a daily count, pero it's the average for a year. And then we have our ADT, or our average daily traffic. So it's obtained through traffic volume counts over a number of days, so at least 2 days and less than 365 days. So, daily traffic din siya, pero not necessarily na-covered natin yung buong taon. So, yun lang yung difference ng AADT saka ng ADT. Pag sinabi nating AADT, we covered the whole year, the period of 1 year. While for ADT, it's a daily traffic which covers at least 2 days, or 2 days to 364 days. So, kung 364 days ka lang nagbilang, then that value is an average daily traffic. Okay? So, for DPWH, they apply now seasonal factors in their counts to have good estimates for your AADT for all national highways. So, kung hindi kaya ang AADT, ang annual average daily traffic, you can use the average daily traffic, pero you have to apply factors. So, daily volumes are useful in our highway planning, maintenance, or repairs of roads. And it cannot be used for design or operational analysis, yung average daily volume ninyo. Okay?
So, Thank you for listening. For your references, you can always check on the book Fundamentals of Traffic Engineering by Ricardo Sigua and the Vehicle Traffic Counting for examples of the video method for counting vehicles.